I would like on your behalf and on behalf of all the comrades here to congratulate Zita for being re-elected as the President of PES Women and to wish her well in the future.
Of course, there is a problem when I'm supposed to speak, then you are very hungry, but I try to be short because I believe that our former group leader, our president of the parliament, made it clear what to do. But let's see the gender perspective, because he spoke about young women, but he should talk about experienced women, because here in the room, we are a lot who are experienced, dear sisters and brothers. Of course, I really would like to thank you for many things. First of all, to be with us. I started with Philip, with Paul Nyrup, and with Lori. That was an extremely good team. And if I should have a wish to you, Paul, please make sure that Nicoletta and Lucas will do the job of the grandfather, because you deserve to get great social democrat in Denmark as well. And of course, Philip, it was fantastic to work with you. And of course, you really deserve to have a next step after 8 years working together with a real fantastic team of the PS. I should congratulate them to make it possible to be here today. Yes, we had difficulties, but how can you make changes for such a short time when you have a great team that they deserve to do the best team of the European Socialists? Of course, I'm very pleased that my sisters, the newly elected PS Women Executive, is here. And I would like to make them visible, because party leaders, when they speak, they forget your name, because it's so natural what you do. But let me make it clear, it is not so natural, because you have to be visible, not only when you are campaigning, but when you are working and we are speaking as well. And of course, I just would like to show this team. I have 4 vice presidents, Mariabel from Holland. Stand up please, because you should see this women. Tuula Peltonen. A great sister of mine, Rovana Plumb, who is not only the Minister of Environment Protection of my friend Victor Ponta's government, but she is the new Vice President of PS Women. And, yeah, she deserves. And of course, as I talked about experienced women, as myself, Anna Karamanu is also in my team as Vice President. And of course, I should talk about Olga Zrinen, Karin Juncker, Marianne Mikko, Marusia Lubcheva, Rula Mavranikola, Andre Mautz. But we made a deal some years ago. Within the PS Women Executive, we would like to be better listened by the Committee of Regions. I'm very proud that Mercedes Bresso is also part of this executive ex officio. Then the newly elected president of Socialist International Women, Wafa Haji, and of course, some of you, or I should say most of you, spoke about young people and young unemployment. I really would like to thank Kaisa Penny from here, from the podium, the job that you have done in the working group of the youth with Nicola Schmidt. And of course, this is true. Are you listening? You cannot do it when you don't have a proper cooperation with the group. I really would like to thank Hannes, the cooperation that we do as PS Women President, as you as group leader, because I believe that you understood you have to do it together with us, and I'm very, very proud of that. And of course, all our movements are very important. And yes, Martin, I'm here to do the fight because I got 100%, so I have the full right to make this European election campaign for all of you. And concerning the new team, of course, Sergei understood it's wise to listen to women. And we will have three vice presidents who are women. I am so honored that Elena Valenciano is going to be our vice president. She sits there, she deserves to be a cricket hands. And of course, former ECOSY vice president Katarina, she is also here. She stand up, please, you should know this should be visible. And of course, we have a great colleague from Great Britain. I wish for you, Emma, I would say, because you were a great advisor for me on gender diversity and integration. I really wish for you a great success. You see how fantastic former colleagues are we have all around Europe. And I just would like to say a last word. October 14, this is the local election for the Belgians. A lot of staff members like Anne Lacey and the others are running, of course from the group, not only from the party, are running for the election. Please make sure that on the Facebook, on the Twitter, you help them, because you are helping them, and of course we are helping them. And of course, we have a lot of work to do. And I just would like to repeat what my former colleague said. This destiny of Europe and the European direction depends on everyday work. If we are the party of the elite, we have no chance to make it. If we are the party, as European Socialists, of ordinary people, party of women and men, disabled, Roma, migrant, then we are the one who is capable to sing in the same voice. And last sentence. I have a dream. And you all know how to continue this dream, just to make it together. But don't forget, you can never do it. And I just would like to remind you, the film with Ginger Rogers and Fred Astaire. She had to do everything backwards and on high heels. Let's turn the direction. You can make it with women. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Sita. I now want you as delegates to see on the screen behind me the new presidency for the PES and the names of the presidency. They will come up fairly soon. And when you've seen them all, I'm going to ask you to vote whether you will accept the nominated presidency for the next term of the PES by all those in favor indicating yes. All those against? Okay. Okay, I'm ruling that the new presidency has been accepted by Congress. Is that accepted? Yeah. It is. Thank you. And now we had to have a recount of the presidential vote. No, it gives me great pleasure to give to you the official votes as cast on behalf of the president. Sergei Stanishev achieved 91.3% of the votes in favour. ...2.4% against and 6.3% abstentions. Sergei, you are our new president elected. Okay, while you're celebrating, I'm going to ask you, the entire family, to come to the stage for a photo shoot. And then at the end of this, Carolina is going to make announcements for the afternoon's business. And we are running a bit late. So while we're assembling to facilitate the photographs, I want to ask the photographers to ensure that we're in the right place. But Sergei, please come.
Thanks a lot.
Okay. We want to call people up for the photograph. You want to say a few words?
A few words.
Okay, I'm going to ask the new president a few words and then family photograph up here on stage. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Rory, and thanks to all of you who supported me, who voted in this challenged elections. But Zita did most of the work before me. She even presented almost the whole future vice president team. But I would like to thank you for the trust. This is a great honor for me personally. This is a great honor to my party and also a big possibility for Bulgaria. And I think it is also a very important sign about what our family is about. Our family is about unity, solidarity, equality, mutual respect, and justice. And I believe that in the EPP, or among the Liberals, not for many years from now on, they couldn't be able to select a president from Central and Eastern Europe. This is a very important political signal to millions of Europeans from the new member states. And this is, of course, a great challenge to me, personally. I remember years when my party was neither in the Socialist International nor in the PES, of course. I remember how many obstacles we had to overcome to get integrated into your family, into our family. And I remember that there were many skeptics, there were many prejudices about Bulgaria joining the European Union, but we did it. And now, I have, for myself, a very strong personal ambition. Together with you, with Martin Schulz, who really is making the European Parliament a political institution and standing for our principles and values and policies as the President of the Parliament, together with Hannes Svoboda as leader of our group, together with the Zita, together with Kajsa as leaders of our member organizations, the PS Women and ECOSY, together with Karl Heinz and with all of us, together with our activists, to achieve our goal in 2014 to win the European elections and to provide real change to Europe, which will be working for the citizens of the continent. Thank you very much again, and all the best, good luck, and let's do our work together.
While the photo has been taken, let me take the opportunity just to give you a few announcements. First of all, we'll convene here in 1 hour, so at 3 p.m. sharply, please, because we'll have the leaders plan panel three. Then our president, Sergei Stanishev, is going to give a press briefing just immediately now over here at my right-hand side at the exit. The youth guarantee meeting is happening in room 300. So everybody interested in that can go there. There is a light lunch provided as well. And for all the others, there is food and refreshments available at the bar, and it is right over there next to the PES 10. So see you here at 3 p.m. sharply. Thank you.
Get the Dr. Honoris Causa.